We have attended weddings and many other Hindu ceremonies, and we have heard about the term called a muhurta. But are you familiar with the concept of a muhurta? Is it astrological or is it simply traditional, having no particular meaning? In the next few minutes, we are going to learn the concept of muhurta. The shadow of a new moon falls to the west after the sunrise, and the length of the shadow is longest at the sunrise. As the sun moves upwards in the sky, the length of the shadow begins to decrease. The unit angula is used to measure the length of the shadow. The eight muhurtas from sunrise to noon are calculated, and they are as depicted.
The first muhurta is the Raudra, which is 96 angulas of shadow length. The second is Shweta, when the length of the shadow is 60 angulas. The third is Maitra, when the length of the shadow is 12 angulas. The fourth is Sarbhata, with 6 angulas shadow length. The fifth is Savitra, with a shadow length of 5 angulas. The sixth being Vairaj, with 4 angulas shadow lengths. The seventh Muhurta is the Vishvasu, with the shadow length of 3 angulas. And eighth is the Abhijata, which has the length of the shadow which is less than 3 angulas.
Yasmin Chaya Pratishthita, meaning the Muhurta in which the shadow is fixed. The Abhijata Muhurta occurs at noon. The shadow is very small, that is less than 3 angula, as the sun is over the head at this time. In the region from the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn, though the sun appears overhead, it is not necessarily at zenith. There are only 2 days in a year when the sun is exactly at the zenith, and the shadow is not cast at local noon, and this also depends on your latitude. These days are called as the zero shadow days. This phenomena can be experienced in India towards the south of the Tropic of Cancer. The first zero shadow day falls between April 9 and June 21. The second falls between June 21 and August 30. As the sun tilts westward, the shadow of Chaya Shankhu falls eastward and gradually grows larger. Thus, the ninth muhurta is again Vishwasu Muhurta. Similarly, in the reverse order, the Raudra Muhurta appears again at the time of sunset. But then what is a good Muhurta? In our video on Vara, we have discussed the concept of Dinadhipati and the Horadhipati. And similarly, we have also discussed the concept of a Graha. So to know more about this, check out our video on Vara. There is a particular ritual in the marriage ceremonies where there are 7 houses called the Gruhas. The houses are nothing but pockets of grains of rice with areca nut or supari placed in the center of each of these Gruhas. Have you ever wondered what they actually mean? Let's try to understand these Gruhas and their relation to a good Muhurta. In the 7 houses, as per the astrological beliefs, the deities are invited to attend the ceremony. In the first house, the Horadhipati, or the Lord of the Hour, is invited. In the second house, the Dinadhipati, or the Lord of the Day, is invited. In the third house, the Nakshatra, in which the moon stays for that day, is invited. Check out our video on the tale of the 27 wives of the moon to know more about the Nakshatras. In the fourth house, the Rashi Swami, or the Master of the Zodiac, which has the Nakshatra of the moon, is invited. In the fifth house, the Graha visible on the eastern horizon is invited. In the sixth house, the Graha visible on the western horizon is invited. Finally, in the seventh house, the Graha which is below the horizon is invited. So then what is a good Muhurta? Let's say a ceremony is to be conducted on a Somvar in the first Hora. So the moon will be invited in the first 2 houses out of the 7 houses. The third house belongs to the Nakshatra in which the moon rests for that day. If the moon is in Pushya Nakshatra, then the third house will also be filled by the moon, because Pushya lies in Karka Rashi. And since the moon is the Lord of Cancer or Karka Rashi, the moon will also occupy the fourth house. And if it's a Purnima, then the Graha visible on the western horizon at the first Hora will also be the moon. And hence the fifth house will also be occupied by the moon. Thus the moon occupies 5 out of 7 houses for this Muhurta. So by inviting a single deity, 5 out of 7 houses can be filled. And such a circumstance is considered as a good Muhurta. Interesting, right? To learn more about such things, follow our page Satyalok on Instagram. Till then, stay tuned, stay educated. And last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Tera kita, 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 tera k